take Bailey out, and then officially start my little morning routine. I tried to wake up a little bit early-ish. I woke up at like 8. I had my alarm set for 8:15, because I have a client at 10. So it just like kind of throws my day. Just a tiny bit. Oh my god, did you guys see that? That is so bright. I'm gonna try and just scoop this in. So I'm definitely gonna see if I can find another container for the contents of that baggie, because I don't think that bag is gonna survive. I don't know if it's just the one that I got or if they're all like that. Also adding one scoop of vanilla whey. It's my favorite flavor. You guys can use my code Lauren to save 10% off. It does have almost like a green tint to it, but it tastes really good. I actually don't taste it at all. And then you also can't taste the lion's mane or the oil. We just made about 22 ounces, and I put it in my blender bottle because I'm probably not going to finish it before. I'm being really indecisive about a storage unit. So technically I have one that's like on hold, but I didn't realize it was so far away. It's like all the way up, like I think past, no, it's like all the way up in like Ansley Park. And it's like, I gotta stop saying like, if I came back here, it would be really nice to be super far north because I wouldn't have traffic coming down into the city. But I'm like, when I'm moving stuff to the storage unit, I'm gonna have to go back and forth and the traffic is just going to be obnoxious. So I'm like, maybe if I can find something on the west side, I might have better luck. I've got 5 minutes to do my makeup, so I'm gonna do like my everyday 5 minute makeup look. So products we use: mascara. This is like the holy grail. This is the best mascara I've ever used, and I love Maybelline. Just a tiny bit of this concealer in the color 385. It's like a little bit too light for me, but we make it work. And then my Revolution contour palette. I use this shade. I always use this shade in my part and stuff on my hair. And then I dab just a tiny bit of this blush from this Revolution Ultra Blush palette. So I got a little extra time, so I thought might as well. And then this is the highlight that I always use that's completely shattered, but we will never let it go. I already see there's an accident, so I'm just gonna email my client and let her know. I'm going to be 5 minutes late. She's really, really strong. I'll link her Instagram down below. So I love working with her because we're able to do like everything and it's so fun. So that was our last session. It was so fun. It's 11:15 now, and I'm gonna head home, hopefully try this blow dryer brush that I got, because obviously this hair is straight. This is actually synthetic too. I'll link it down below if you guys are interested in it. I got this from the beauty supply shop and I'm obsessed with it. This is also by Sensational. My other one was too, and I really, really liked it. This quality though is 100 times better than that other one. The other one just tangled a lot because it was curly. This one's really long and straight, but like, I don't know, the tangling really is not that bad. I was very surprised. So highly, highly recommend. If you get it from the beauty supply store, it's like $30 more. I got a discount though, because I got it straight off of the wig head, because it was the last one that they had. But you can get it on Amazon, so I'll try and link the Amazon one down below. But I want to try this blowout brush that I have, and then the next time I wash my hair, I'll try that out too, because I use a brush, but it's not like the round blowout brush like this one is. So I'd be interested to see how that works with my curls and stuff. But homegirl's so strong. So we went for a squat PR today because I was like, I'm here, like, we might as well actually see how much you can squat. She could definitely squat a lot more than what we worked up to, which was 155, but I was like, we'll just cap it here. Just gives you more confidence when you're squatting in the gym by yourself to go a little bit heavier. And she did 2 pull-ups, so she's been working on pull-ups and recently just got her first one. So today she did 2 back-to-back, and that was the last exercise that we did, which is impressive. So it was fun. I'm meeting Katarina in an hour, so I'm gonna take Bailey for a walk for about 20-30 minutes, and then I'll come back and we'll try out the blow dryer brush. This is what it looks like. I'm very excited. Where's your tripod, Lauren? I don't know. Probably nearby. This is what it looks like, so I'll link it down below if you want to check it out. It is the Cortex Beauty Volumizing Blowout Brush. So it's really made for blowouts, and it's huge, and it's so pretty. So it does have the cool shot function. This comes with an extended life with removable filter, multi-heat settings, and 1200 watt power. So I'm really pumped. I've never used one of these before because I'm a black person. So this is a big moment for me, but it's really cool. And rose gold is one of my favorite colors. I'm actually getting my Justin Clow bracelet replaced. I don't know if you've noticed, but this wrist has been empty for months because that bracelet disappeared. I don't know what happened to it. I somehow lost it, and I really don't know how. But this one's still holding on strong, but I did get a insurance policy for it, so I finally sorted that through, and I'm gonna get a new one, and I'm gonna do rose gold instead of the gold. That's why I brought that up. We got the long lead on. A little freedom. Not too much. Normally I do off-leash, but there's just too many dogs outside. So I don't know if it's because of allergies or because it's cold outside. It's actually, okay, so it's not really cold. It's like 60 degrees out, but it's so, so windy. It's like 50 miles per hour wind, which is like thunderstorm weather. Like, it's just very, very windy. It's very odd. So I'm gonna go ahead and take allergy medicine just in case, because we are going to be outside, but we're going to go to the little like downtown EAV area. I've been to their farmer's market, but I don't think I've ever actually like truly walked around East Atlanta Village. So I am excited. And she said there is a bagel shop and a coffee shop. And she said the bagel shop has gluten-free bagels and vegan cream cheese. So I don't know if we're going there, but she was telling me about it. But I want to show you guys what I'm thinking for my outfit. You'll have to let me know what you like better. Obviously I'm gonna choose whatever I want, but we have two options. So jeans, cargo pants, Moment are from Shein, shocker. And then this long sleeve top is from Adore Me. So it's just like this really nice stretchy material. It's actually pretty long. I just have it tucked in, but I love these cargo pants. Really nice. I'm gonna wear my black short Uggs with them. So jacket choices. We've got this jacket that my mom gave me. She was never able to figure out how to wear it because it's like very weird. It's very high fashion. It's asymmetrical, but it's really warm. So like, as you can see, it's like actually supposed to look like this. And this tie is supposed to go like through a loop or something. I think it's supposed to be like this, and you like tie it in a bow, something like that. I don't know, but I was like, you know what? I could probably make this work. It's like a little bit extra, but so am I. And then our second choice is something I haven't shown you guys yet, but I've had for a minute. So I thought I would show you two of my newest luxury pieces I have not worn yet. It is this Louis Vuitton vest. So it's got like their print on the inside, and then the outside's like this really pretty apricot. I have the tags on it still and everything. But it is an oversized vest. Did I put this on right? I don't think so. Something weird happening here. Oh no, I unbuttoned it. So you can unbutton it so it can be like bigger or looser kind of on your body. And I really like that. So you guys know I love that padded Shein one that I have, but this one has a hood. So it's like super oversized, but I think it's so cute. And it's got the zipper. So if I wear this will be the first time wearing it. I haven't really been anywhere in Atlanta in a while when it's been cold where, you know, I could dress like sort of kind of nicely. So I thought it was really cute. I love the details. I think Louis Vuitton's monogram is my favorite, either them or Fendi. But I don't know, it really just depends. Cause like this is cute, but the jacket will technically keep me warmer. So I don't know. And then the last thing that I have that is new, I haven't shown you guys yet, is from Bottega. And I might actually use this bag today since I'm wearing all black for a little pop. And it is the Mini Jody. So this is the older style. But it's really pretty. It's got like pretty gold details. And this bag is a lot bigger than I thought it would be like on the inside. You can actually fit so much stuff in there. So it's just, you know, a little crook of the arm or just holding moment. So sadly she canceled like right as I was walking out the door. She said she has really bad cramps. So I am just gonna go to H Mart and do my grocery shopping. I don't know yet if I'm also going to go to Kroger, but I definitely wanna go to H Mart. I wanted to go last week and I never went. Because I really want to make kimchi soup again with the rice cakes and hot dogs. It's so good. And then I think I'm gonna make I don't know why I'm blanking on what it's called. Kimbap. Yeah, so I'm gonna make kimbap again. I still have some radish and some carrot, so I think I'm also going to use hot dogs for that. So I'll definitely be getting hot dogs from Amazon Fresh or from Kroger, because it'll just be so much cheaper than getting it from H Mart. But we're gonna do kimchi soup, kimbap, and then I have rice at home, so probably just make some sort of dish with rice. I don't want to get too much stuff because like I'm moving and stuff is gonna have to come with me, and I'd rather not transport that. So I'm really just trying to have dry stuff that's left over, if anything. It's not possible to actually be anywhere near this H Mart. Like, it is packed
Ow.
I can't open my thing.
Oh, also, I don't know. I guess if you guys follow me on Instagram, you already know, because that was like a whole entire thing. But my car was broken into like a couple weeks ago, and they stole a dollar from me. And I think about it every single time I open my middle console. They did not take anything else. Not that I had anything in my car to take, but they literally had the audacity to leave my car with a dollar. So that's great. Love that. I really thought I was going to get out of Atlanta without having my window smashed, but they were like, we have to give her the full experience. There's no way we can let her leave without her property being damaged. So that's always fun. I'm currently sweating, but I know it's cold outside. I'm like, do I want to wear this in H Mart? I don't remember if it's cold in there or not. I don't remember. I did bring my AirPods though. Not that anybody would talk to me here. I feel like this is like a normal grocery store. I feel like it's Kroger where like I have to have my AirPods. Otherwise, there's just men constantly harassing me in the grocery store where I can't escape because I'm grocery shopping. So that's always fun. H Mart. I wish they weren't only like all the way out in the suburbs, but I am hoping that there will be an H Mart somewhere near my parents' house, because we used to have one probably like 10 minutes from our old place, and it was so nice. My mom and I used to go there all the time. We lived by a bunch of grocery stores. It was kind of weird. I am already confused. I don't know. I don't have a code. Is there like a... Can I just call? I'm just gonna call and see what they say. Maybe I'm at the wrong entrance, but this is like where the address took me.
Thank you for calling Public Storage. We are located at...
That was such a journey. I finally found it. The lady gave me a call back. She said she had stepped out to help some people that were moving out, and so naturally she wasn't at the phone, which is fine. I feel like I have to pee my pants now, so I'm hoping I go to the bathroom. TMI. But, yeah, I was just on the wrong side, and like I felt like I was on the wrong side, but where I was, I just could not figure out like where else I could possibly need to be. And when you type it into maps, it just keeps taking you to the back exit. She's on the phone, so I'm waiting, but I hope it's big enough. That's really all I'm worried about. I don't know why it wouldn't be, but we'll have to see. So I'm in the elevator now. I had to put a code in outside to use it. I sat here for a second, very confused. Stood here. So the space is a really good size. It's gonna be perfect. It's probably more than enough space, to be honest. So let's see. What is my number again? This way. I feel like I'm in Dexter, to be honest. That's all I can think about. So here it is. So it's pretty high. I believe they said it's about 8 feet high, and then it is 10 feet across, and then 5 feet wide. So
They did give me
a lock, which I paid like $20 for. This was not something that I asked to have. It was just something that I guess you just get no matter what, but I'm not complaining. So, it's a pretty heavy duty lock. And keys. Naturally having a full-blown photo shoot in the storage unit.
But that was really easy, so I don't know if I think I'm gonna start moving stuff in on my own. There is an elevator, so I don't have to worry about that. And let me put this stuff away. And most of my stuff is gonna be in containers and boxes, and the furniture should be able to be stacked really, really easily. Because I think we're gonna do like some sort of U-Haul truck to make it really easy. She said there's a place where I went originally, the back, where you can pull in and you can back up. So I'm probably gonna do that.
I'm so glad I was able to get that out of the way today because the traffic over here is really bad, and I just know it would have been so hard trying to do this during the week because I originally had my reservation for Thursday. And I actually accidentally made a brand new reservation for today, so I had two reservations, but I ended up with the cheaper unit. So it's only $89 a month, which is very, very cheap. Because I looked at so many different storage companies and spaces, and unfortunately all the spaces near me were completely gone, and they only had really, really big units for like $200, $300 a month. Or really small units, and it just wasn't worth getting a bigger one because the whole thing that I'm trying to do is to know for sure that whatever U-Haul I choose, I know for a fact that all of my stuff will fit in it. Homie, I have my turn signal on, so be nice.
Follow me on Instagram, you know this, but I recently caved and started Love is Blind, but I only watched the second season because the drama I was hearing from it, I was like, I have to watch this show now, I'm too nosy. But I haven't seen the first one. And the setup was actually cool. I thought it was gonna be like so silly, to be honest, to put it nicely, but I actually really enjoyed it. So we're gonna check out the first season now and see how it does.